All right, everybody. Hey, welcome back for our noontime Zoom. So today's workout, we'll do a quick little warm up as usual. We'll hit three blocks. All right, our first block, we'll do some core work. Second block, we're gonna do some total body strength. And then our last block for today, we're gonna hit some plyo work. All right, so we're gonna get some plyometrics in there, get some explosive work in there to finish it up. All right, warm up. Let's get started here. We're gonna go about 5 minute warm up. We're gonna start with some spider lunges. All right, so we're just alternating legs. Step that right leg up, pause, hold that position, and drive that knee forward a little bit. Turn to the side. If you're working some ankle mobility, you can take that elbow, drop it down to the ground, lock out that back leg, posture up. And you're just alternating on your own here. All right. Just get a good stretch, just get in what you need. Get loose a little bit. Drop that knee around, sink those hips down. Alternating legs. So you're alternating at your own pace here. Right, so kind of adding in what you need to do to get ready for today's workout. You need to hold that stretch a little bit longer. Hold that stretch a little bit longer. All right, after that, we're staying in this push-up position. And we're gonna hit some step-ins. Alternating legs here. All right, jump up here. Fix the computer real quick. Everybody else, just keep getting that stretch in. Perfect. Here we go. Good. So we're getting those step-ins. Just alternating legs. Again, on those step-ins, you always work those arms out. Reach overhead. So if my right leg is forward, I'm reaching over with my left. Getting that stretch in my lats and my obliques there. Alternating on your own. Walk those arms out, bring those arms overhead. So you're getting glute, opposite side lat, oblique. You can always stay up tall here. Lock out that back leg. Good, we're gonna stand it up from here. So moving around a little bit, we're gonna go isolateral lunge, so our feet are going to stay in a static position. We're going to lunge down to the right, left arm down, reach up right arm, stand up, lunge down to the left, right arm down, reach left. Again, you're just alternating sides on your own. Hold that stretch as long as you need to. We'll get a few more of these. And then we're going to turn this into a little bit of good. Now we're going to switch, bring those legs in, and we're going to go dynamic hamstrings. So what we're going to do, I'll turn to the side here. We're just going to get a little squat, sink down, drive those knees out the elbows, rock side to side here a little bit, grab the toes, lock the legs out. Move your hamstring back down into that squat. Move side to side. Work on some ankle mobility here. Lock those legs out. So just moving back and forth. You'll notice here when I do these hamstring stretches, I'll bend like my right knee, drag my left hip back, then bend my left knee, drag my right hip back. Just get a little extra hamstring stretch. Around here, make sure you try to keep those feet flat on those squats. Good. All right, now we're going to get back down to the ground. We're going to do some leg overs. Roll my back, drive my right knee into the chest, take my right leg, lock it out to the left, my right shoulder on the ground. That stretch for a few seconds, then switch it up. So a good stretch in the hamstrings and the low back. If you can grab your toes, great. This kind of helps get a little bit better of a hamstring stretch, I feel like, but if you can't grab those toes, that's fine. Just straighten out that leg as best you can. You can even from here. If you're able to grab the toes, bend that knee, flex the quad, or I'm sorry, lock out that knee, flex the quad, bend the knee to relax, lock it out again, so you get a couple of these movements here in the leg, and then switch up to the other side. Good. All right. Again, if you need to get some extra stretching in, get yourself ready. Go do that. And then as soon as you're warmed up, just jump right back in. All right. But otherwise, we're going to move on here. We're going to start into our core section. So for this, we're going to go four exercises. We're going to go plank variation for 1 minute straight. I'm just going to switch it up on you. So just kind of follow through and move with me. After that, we're going to go side planks, 30 seconds each side. Then we're going to go switch into alternating single leg pikes for 30 seconds straight. Then we're going to go single leg glute bridge, 30 on each side. And we're going to run that back around again, and we'll do two full rounds of that. All right? Here we go. Let's get started. So just keep it easy on you for first couple seconds. We're just going to go regular planks, all right? So we're in this low plank position. Shoulders are over the elbows. Back should be flat. Abs tight. Just gonna hold this here. Good. Now what we're gonna start doing is gonna work into up downs. So we're just gonna walk it up, walk it down, walk it up, walk it down, keep moving here. Nice and controlled. Come up to that high plank position, hold it, and we're gonna work shoulder taps. Up, touch, hold, 2-3 seconds, back down, switch. Up, touch, hold, 2-3 seconds, back down, switch. Walk back into those. Now we're gonna go into those up plank, up downs again. So work it up and down here. Keep moving. And hold here, low plank position, 10 seconds. 5 more seconds, just holding here. 3, 2, and relax, good. All right, now we're gonna go side planks. 30 seconds each side, all right? Ready, and go, hips up. Now we're gonna add some variations to this. We're gonna start here, keep those hips up high. And we're gonna start adding in a knee drive. Top knee, drive it up, nice control. Now you're following along at home. If you have to, again, you can always cut into that assisted side plank position. All right, now keep those legs stacked. We're just gonna go rotational side plank. Reach all the way back, open up, reach back, open up, and relax, good. Switching it up, other side, same thing, right? So we're gonna start 10 seconds, regular side plank, 10 seconds knee drive, 10 seconds rotational side plank, so working those plank variations. Everybody's up, hips up high, feet are stacked. And again, you're making that assisted side plank position modification at home on your own if you need to. All right, ready? Knee drive. Drive that knee up, back down, stack those legs, but keep those hips up, right? So don't let those hips drop. Here we go, now add in the rotation. Keep going, a couple seconds here. Nice, relax. All right, now we're gonna go alternating single leg pikes, alternating legs, 30 seconds. Here we go, ready? And go. Reach that right hand up to the left toe, left hand to the right toe, alternating legs, sitting all the way up. Try to keep those legs straight. Crush some abs here. Keep those abs right. We're halfway, so keep moving. We got 10 more seconds. Keep going. 5 more seconds. Up, down, and relax. All right, now we got alternating single leg glute bridge. All right, so we'll go start with the right knee down, left knee up, all right? We're gonna go 30 seconds on the right leg, and then 30 seconds on the left. Ready, and go. So we're lifting up and back down, all right? Now, if you have to, right, if you're feeling this in that left leg a lot, or I'm sorry, in the left leg, in the hamstring, go double leg. All right, drive that heel down, drive that hip up. Going, talking here, and I'm trying to watch the timer at the same time, get distracted. A couple more seconds, And we're switching right into that left leg. Go. So drive up, squeeze through the top, pause, hold, back down. So it's not a tempo, but let's just make sure that movement's controlled, contracting the muscles. Again, if you're feeling this in the hamstring a lot, just switch to a double leg glute bridge. All right, and we'll just do it for a minute. Add a little tempo in at the top. And if the single leg is too easy for you, add a tempo. 3 to 5 second hold the top, set your pattern down. Good, relax. These are some quick ways.
You can always modify these workouts at home on your own. All right,
planks, get right back into it, round two. And we're just gonna jump into it. We're gonna keep this moving. Here we go, ready and go. So we're starting off with our regular plank. Then we're gonna work in some variations with that, the up downs and the shoulder taps. So a couple more seconds here, and let's go into the up downs, ready? Up, down, walking it up and down here. Nice and controlled, but keep moving if you can. Alternate the arms. All right, now we're gonna go up, high plank position. Now it's bring it up, shoulder tap, pause, hold, back down, switch. Shoulder tap, pause, hold. Now on these shoulder taps, watch those hips turning. So shoulders should be over the wrists, abs tight, back flat, hips squared up. Last 10 seconds, let's bring it back down. Normal plank position. 5 seconds, 3, 2, and relax. Good. All right. Working our side planks now. Again, we're going to work some plank variations there too. So at home, if you need to, use that assisted side plank position. Go your normal side plank position where the feet are stacked and the hips are up. We can add in the variations like we're doing where we're going knee drive and with that side plank in the rotation. All right. We're up. 30 seconds. Clock is going. Keep those shoulders stacked, so chest is up, shoulders are back. I'm working on pinching my shoulder blades here. Keep my hips up. All right, we're adding in that knee drive. Drive that knee up. Again, you can do this from that assisted side plank position if you need to. All right, now go to rotation here. So reach, open up. 3 more seconds here. And relax. All right, side planks, and go. We're up, keep holding here. Let's get this clock going. All right, knee drive. Grab that knee to the waist. Keep those hips up high. Don't let those hips drop down on that knee drive. If those hips are dropping on the knee drive, add in that rotation now. Just take the knee drive out. Open it up, reach under, and relax. All right, roll right to your back there, and we've got alternating single leg pikes, 30 seconds total. Ready, and go. And we'll go all the way up, trying to keep those legs straight, get a little active hamstring stretch. So all the way up, reach the hand up to the toes. Halfway, keep moving. Sage Wolf here in the background, one of my new favorite bands. And relax. All right, stay on your back. Single leg glute bridge. 30 seconds on the right leg. Lift those hips up and down. Ready? And go. Stop. Squeeze, pause at the top, back down, repeat. There is no tempo, but again, you can add that tempo in at home. You want to switch things up a little bit, try to make it a little bit more challenging. You can hold at the top for the 30 seconds. You can do a 3 to 5 second hold at the top. You can do a 3 to 5 second concentric down. 5 seconds. And switch right into the other leg now, left leg. Hips down, hips up. Feeling this in the hamstrings, go to that double leg. Drive to that heel, drive Drive those hips up. Squeeze the top. We're almost there, 10 seconds. Keep going, a few more. Good, relax.
All right,
perfect. That was two rounds of our core block. Get a quick drink, and then we'll go through block two. All right, so for this block, we've got, this is gonna be more total body, this block. No weights, all body weight. Five exercises. We're gonna do 30 seconds on, 15 seconds off, a little rest at the end of each round, and we're gonna go three rounds for that. All right, so we've got body weight squat, push up with a shoulder tap, squat jumps, reverse crunch to 6 inches, and then high knees, all right? So now, if you do have weights at home and you wanna add them in, go for it, right? Do some goblet squats, hold them at your sides for the squats, get a medicine ball so you can always add that in. Hold a medicine on the squat jump, so you can always add those things in again if you want to change it up a little bit for yourself. But otherwise, we are full body weight here, and we're gonna get started. All right, so we got body weight squats, 30 seconds, ready? And go. So we're just down, up, all right? Good technique, we're gonna turn to the side here. Make sure we're sitting those hips back. So our feet should stay flat the whole time. So as you sit back and squat back, I don't want those heels lifting up off the ground. Now tempo here, low tempo. And again, it's always one of those things that you can add in to switch things up a little bit for yourself. Couple more seconds here. Relax. 15 seconds. We're on the ground. We're going to go push up, shoulder tap. So we're going to do a push up, come up, shoulder tap right, shoulder tap left, and then repeat. We're going to do that for 30 seconds. All right, here we go. Let's get that clock started. Push up to shoulder tap, 30 seconds. Go. All the way down, up, shoulder tap, shoulder tap. Try to get little 2 to 3 second hold on that shoulder tap there. All right, adjust the feet, so the width of the feet as you need to, so you have a good 3-point base of support. When you do that shoulder tap, you don't want those hips turning. Push-ups, good form, right? Everything up and down together. Last 30 seconds. Goes fast, all right? We're moving fast in this. We're not getting a lot of rest in between. 30 seconds work, 15 seconds rest, and we're right back into it. So we're squat jumps here, hands on our hips. All right, and we're going. Ready? Go. Hands on the hips. All right, height, whatever you can. More about speed here, trying to get a lot of good quality reps as we're moving. We're gonna turn to the side here again. Just so you can see as I land, right, I'm sitting my hips back every time. So I sit back onto my heels, much like we did with our squats. So we got 5 seconds. Keep moving. So those quads start to burn a little bit. Relax. I don't know about anybody else, but my quads always burn a little bit when we get those squats up. So, all right. Reverse crunch, 6 inches. So we're on the ground. Tuck my shirt in here. All right. Here we go. We're gonna go, keep your head on the ground, hands right next to your head right here. We're gonna start in that 6-inch position, knees, elbows, curl those hips up, and then back down. All right, here we go, 30 seconds, ready? Go. Now in here, if you have to, you can cut out that 6-inch part and just work short distance, right, knees over the hips. Throw it in these elbows for that reverse crunch. So, some options you have there. Just do what you need to do. All right, let's keep going here. Elbows in, hips up. And we're done, 30 seconds. Good time. All right, now we're up on our knees. And we're going high knees, 30 seconds. So we're just getting some good cardio here. All right. Just working in place. Ready? And go. Knees up. Heels up. Work those arms. So we're right here. Just good, quick movements. Good continuous movement. So this is kind of like a cardio movement for us at the end here. 10 more seconds. We got 5 seconds, keep going. And relax. Awesome, all right. Now you get 30 seconds. Grab a quick drink if you need it. At 30 seconds, it's gonna go fast. All right, everything's staying the same. Round two, same 5 exercises, nothing new here. Now we know what we're doing, so we should be able to get after it a little bit more in the second round, all right? Starting with body weight squats, 30 seconds. Let's get it, ready? And go. Good form. Try to get down the parallel if you can, while keeping those feet flat. All right, so there should be really no movement in the feet as you squat down. So watch those heels turning in, the toes turning out. If you see a lot of that in your squats, try working on your ankle mobility, all right? Those ankles are probably tight, and that's where you're seeing a lot of that movement at the bottom of the squat, or hip flexors might be tight. A lot of those muscles in the lower body might be tight just from sitting around doing our virtual workouts, or virtual class. All right. We got 5 seconds here, and we've got our push-ups with the shoulder taps. All right, here we go, ready? And go. Just the width of those feet, so you're in a good balanced position. Elbows, they should be glued to your lats, and they're not pointing straight outside the shoulder. They're somewhere in between, like a 45 degree angle there. 10 more seconds. Going. 2-3 second hold. I rushed those last couple there. That's my fault. Up. 1-2. Down. 1-2. Down. Good. Relax. Back up on our feet. Squat jumps. Now you can go hands on the hips. You can move those arms if you want. That's up to you. Any one of those is fine as long as you're doing squat jumps. All right. Here we go. 30 seconds. Ready? Go. Sit those hips back. Nice, quick, reactive jumps. So as soon as you land, you sit those hips back, right? And you're going right into that jump. Hands on the hips, and again, you can move those arms if you want. All right, I'm adding it in now, just so you can see. Just basically a little arm swing. Hands and hips, moving in the same direction. More of a total body, relax. Movement that way when you get those arms involved. But big thing is, if you're incorporating the arms, make sure the movement pattern is coordinated, just like you saw me do when I'm jump up, my arms are up. When I land, I'm bringing my arms down. All right, we're on the ground. Reverse crunches. Get it. Shirt in for these. All right, good song. Here we go. We'll turn it up a little bit. You guys can hear a little more music and a little less big. Ready? Go. I'm just going to let this song play for 30 seconds. I'm going to shut up. I'm just going to work. We're going to work. Last one. Awesome. Here we go. We're up on the feet here. Reverse crunches. Again, round two. Like I said, we know what we're doing here. So I'm going to quiet down for 30 seconds. Let you guys listen to some music. And we're just going to get after it with the high knees. All right. Ready? And go. Push that pace. arms work, knees work, and let's go. F1. Ten seconds, come on. Five. Done. 30 seconds, get some water. Woo. Got one more round of that. All right, quick little drink. All right, round three. Let's get after it here, right? Five exercises, 30 seconds each. Really, all that boils down to is just 2.5 minutes of straight work, right? It takes us a little bit longer to get through because we've got that 15 seconds of rest, but we're only doing 2.5 minutes of work, right? So we can do this. Let's get in here. All right, body weight squats, 30 seconds, go. Keep going. All right, work that pace. Adding in a nice little hold. We can do that. I'm gonna show you how to do that right now, ready? Everybody down, hold with me. 5 seconds. This is an ISO hold here. And go. Rep it out now. Rep it out. Move quick. Relax. I'm sure I'm going to feel that on those squats. All right. 10 seconds here. We're on the ground. Push-ups. Don't forget the hold on the shoulder tap. We don't want to rush those shoulder taps, all right? Good 2-3 second ISO hold on each one. All right. Ready? Go. I just rushed it. One, two. One, two. I'm cutting it down to a 2 second hold here. I'm going to try to get a few more push-ups in. 10 seconds. Almost there, come on. Keep those hips squared up. So when you go to that shoulder tap, that 3-point position, try not to let those hips turn. Last. Good. All right, up on our feet, squat jumps. So again, that second round, I showed you 2 options. You go hands on the hips, we can move those arms. Whichever one works for you is fine. Just make sure we're working. All right, squat jumps, 30 seconds, go. Keep moving. Down, touch, up, jump. Sit those hips back, watch again. As soon as I land, dropping the hips, just like I would on the squats. Halfway. All right, we got 10 seconds. I'm switching the arms. Here we go. Almost there. A couple more seconds. Relax. Perfect. All right. Let's get ready to get to the ground. First crunch. Push it in again. All right. We're ready. 30 seconds. Ready? Go. 30 seconds. Sorry. I guess it's 15. Drop it out 6 inches if you can. If not, it wasn't this position right here. Either one is fine. Just keep working. Keep that back flat. If you are extending those legs up to 6 inches, keep that back flat. Don't let the back arch up off the ground. Relax. All right. Last exercise in this block. High knees. We're getting there. All right, here we go. Ready? 30 seconds. Let's get it. Go. Arms, knees, keep moving. Come on. We're halfway, 15 seconds. Try to pick that tempo up. 10. Come on, pick it up now, 5 seconds. Nice. Good job. All right, get some water. You don't have water and you don't need it, that's fine. Just catch your breath, give it a minute. We'll go through our next block here, our last block. So, our last block here, we're doing all plyometric work. We're just doing two rounds, six total reps of each movement. All right. So we're gonna go a vertical jump into a broad jump. That'll be one, the turn around, vertical jump, broad jump, all right? The height of your vert, the distance of your broad jump, right? That's all up to you, and it's also based upon how much space you have where you're at, right? You might be at home, you might not have as much space, so you might have to shorten up jumps just because of that, and if you do, you can always just add in a couple extra reps if you want, right? After that, we're gonna go cycle split squat jumps, which will be six total reps, and then we're gonna go plyo push-ups for six. If you can't get the hand clap, just try to pop the hands off the ground. If you can't pop the hands off the ground, just do normal push-ups, all right? We'll talk through it. And again, as long as we're doing something, right? We're trying to get ourselves better. That's the most important thing. So let me show you the vertical jump to the broad jump real quick. So we're gonna go here, down, jump, and then out into the broad jump, all right? So it's gonna be here, down, vertical jump, broad jump. And that'll be two reps. All right, then we'll rest. Cycle split squat jumps. It's here, six total. And then plyo push-ups, we're up and clapping the hands. All right, here we go. Break time is over. Vertical jump first into your broad jump. That's one rep. Let's turn this music up a little bit. We're gonna need some of this. All right, here we go, ready? Vert, down, broad jump. That's one, turn it around. Vert, broad jump, two. Vert, broad jump, three. Here we go, one. Up, out, four. Two more. Woo. Wow, I'm gonna do my broad jump first. That's okay. Caught myself though. There we go. Nice. All right, 15 seconds. Now again, focus is on speed and power here, so if you need to take a few extra seconds, do it. We want to make sure we're getting quality movements. All right, we got 10 seconds. Six total cycles, split squat jumps, so every jump counts as a rep. 3 seconds, here we go. Ready? Down our lunge position, right leg forward, and go. One, two, punch those arms up as you jump. Three, four, five, six, down, sticking. Perfect. All right. Walk it out. Shake those legs out. Feel them a little bit by now. All right. We got six plyo push-ups. Any kind of explosive push-up or just a push-up, right? Just get something here for six reps. All right, here we go. Let's see how these go. Come on, let's get it. Ready? Down, up. One, two, three, four, five, six. Catch yourself on the way down. Awesome. All right. 30 seconds, just like the other round. Walk it out. Shake those arms out. Shake those legs out. This is our last block. All right. Each exercise, one more time, and then we're done. Let's see if we can get ourselves a good song here to get moving. Get something. Here we go. All right. Here we go. Vertical jump, roll jump. Six reps. Let's get it. Vert. Roll jump. One. Vert. Roll jump. Up. Come on, halfway on this. Over and back. Over and back. Come on. Vert. Jump. One more. Here we go. Come on. Vertical. Roll jump. There we go. All right. Two more. Cycle split squat jumps. We got 10 seconds. Catch your breath. Shake those legs out. 5 seconds. All right, let's go. Six good ones. Ready? Get it. One, two, three, four, five, six. Stick and hold. Awesome. Walk it out. 15 seconds. Six. Final push up. And we are done our lunchtime Zoom. All right, let's start getting set. All right, here we go. Five, six push ups anyway. Just get something here. Ready? Go. Three, four, five. Last one. Good. Awesome work, everybody. Great job. That is your noontime Zoom. See you guys next time. Next.